your melee creeps and you're able to get pulverizers every single time. So as soon as it looks like you're about to pop that shield, just means that you're going to get a headbutt pulled.
Well, Spook's looking for the parallel convergence. There's the stun. He gets the shield as well. Ryu going to get taken down easy as you like. And that's the power of the Echo Jungle, ladies and gentlemen. If you can coordinate where that player is going to be, you're going to stun him up, get a shield, and everything's going to be done. So escape route. And it's going to be fun. Equalizer was used in the top lane. His devastating charge going to bring Ryu back into the minion wave. The caster creep's doing work, and Swiper locks down the 1v1.
Yeah, and it's funny because, wow.
Yep, another one comes through here as Miss Fish going to tunnel away. There's a parallel convergence. Oh my goodness, that rupture was fantastic. Swiper blows his whole load to pick up that kill, and they're going to transition into the Dragon.
Yeah, so Dragon going to be picked up nice and early here. T-Gun trying to get in there to mix it up, but it looks like it will fall down.
Yep, easily taken down there as the Chiefs just with so much aggression. The teleport to be used in the top lane as well as immunity. They know that they're not going to pick that one up, and Radiant heads back down to the bottom side of the map. It's going to try and not give it up without a fight. Headbutt under T-Gun back into the team here.
The Venn diagram.
Oh, look at it. So many circles, ladies and gentlemen, as T-Gun is pretty tanky actually at this stage, but not tanky enough. Z-Drive Resonance is going to be enough to lock down that kill, and Spooks 2-0-1 now.
Back, finish up that Trinity Force. And this is the thing about not going Cinderhulk, because Cheese in trouble.
Yep, there's the Flash Pulverize. Cheese gets delivered underneath the turret. Swiffer was tanking that one up, but just decides he's going to take it out instead as Chaos Storm is just going to be maneuvered under there, but doesn't quite have the time on it. And Chiefs lock down the outer turret in the mid lane.
Yeah, they certainly do. That completes the whole outer ring. Radius still down in the bottom turret, farming up an absolute storm after getting killed a couple of times. Very unhappy with that, I am sure. But now 4 turrets to 2, they've extended the gold lead to 5,000. This is what the Chiefs do fantastically. Play the mid game, open up the map, and get every advantage they can. It's just so worthwhile.
Well, Ejim is going to headbutt T-Gun towards his team, actually. There's the gravity field stunning him up. Parallel Convergence is down here as Spooks looking for Cheese, but doesn't get there. T-Gun taking a lot of damage. Swiffer pretty safe in the backline as Misfish trying to zone him out. Zenk as well using Vision nicely, but Swiper destroys Cheese. The Equalizer from Ryu in a great spot, but he's going to die. And the double kill for Swiffer. Cheese just all over that team fight. Zenk survived, but he's the only one.
He's only level 12.
Yeah, Misfish actually getting lasered as well as he gets stunned up by the gravity field. Swiffer still playing very aggressively. Zenk and Cheese, all the damage. The rocket jump actually used to get Zenk over the wall now as Z-Drive Resonance. Actually, no, it was a headbutt from EJ. Makes his way in. There's the Chaos Storm. So much damage as Smooks is going to lock up the rest of the IM members trying to get some work done here as he's parallel. Oh my gosh, the ultimate from Spooks as well to get him out of the position. And there's the time winder for the slow radio coming through now. And T-Gun just getting torn to shreds. The 3-item Lucian, or 2.5 with the triple kill now as the Chiefs able to take down this inner turret in the top side. Baron buff still ticking, and that whole time it was a 4v5.
Yeah, exactly right. So Swiper cleans up the base on the back end as well. They're going to grab a second inhibitor as well. Zenk looks on in absolute horror. He's terrified.
Yeah. Well, look, inhibitor goes in the bottom side of the map. Chiefs just going to remove the top inhibitor as well.
Need
and immunity.
Be careful. Their 5 members are about to be up for immunity. They're quite low.
Yeah, well, if they do it again, Swiper will probably take the last inhibitor as well.
Maybe one major item above, but the cost-efficient builds are coming through from immunity, so they're trying to scrape things together, looking for another pick.
Yeah, trying to pick off Radio here. Uses the flash to get out, and Misfish, forced to retreat, is just going to die there. Parallel convergence, not necessary, but Spooks making sure that the follow-up was available. Swiper now looking to try and get in with the Onslaught of Shadows as immunity. They're setting up a stall around this inner turret. Swiper just decides he'll bypass it and just head towards Nexus turrets. The inner turret is going to fall down. Swiper just being a menace.
Yeah, he certainly is. And you see the top minion wave also there as well.
Yeah, there's a shockwave under Spooks, who just looks for Cheese there. Does end up using the E on the turret, though, which is not exactly the best maneuver. Zenk very, very low. T-Gun going to fall down. There's a Chaos Storm under Cheese as the culling comes through. Nice ult, nice flash, sorry, to get Cheese out of danger there. And Z-Drive Resonance unable to be propped, but Swiper, he's on a mission. The Trinity Force doing work to these turrets as well as Spooks heading in there. All the members of Chiefs, still alive. Parallel Convergence is going to make a nice circle, slowing down immunity just a little bit. But the Nexus is going to fall down. The Chiefs with a dominant performance. And immunity, they had some moments of glory, and definitely the early game was going better for them than...